let's bring you into a new universe. A universe filled with templates, just like this template we're going to talk about in today's video. Softr Universe was something we launched a month or so back, and in this video, I'm going to dive into a customer onboarding template that was created by Matthew Chateau, sorry if I pronounced that wrong, who created a really cool customer onboarding template. Because we wanted to show you how to create a customer onboarding app inside of Softr, we figured, hey Matt, thank you for creating this. Let's dive into an amazing template that allows you to make this kind of app very easily. But first of all, what is a customer onboarding app and why should you have one? Well, when a customer joins or wants to join the business, they need to learn the value that you're giving them. And this is done during the customer onboarding when they are signing up and using your product or service. To systemize this process, it is great to use Softr to create a smooth experience from the first time the customer learns about the business to the post-purchase stage. With this template, your team can assign and track the different onboarding tasks and share resources or checklists with those customers that are onboarding. So I'm gonna just click use template, make sure to check out the template in the link down below, but by pressing this template and connecting it to my Airtable and copying the base to my account and then adding base, you'll see that we have multiple different bases here. We have user credentials, so the different users are in two categories, one for team member and one for customer. We have a user onboarding information base. We have data to display for a donut chart. We have resources for onboarding. We have help inquiries, and we have a base that explains some Airtable automations. So let me go back and create this app to get things started inside Softr. Now I'm going to publish this template and go to the user section, take one of these magic links and give you a look around. David in this email example is a customer. So this is going to be from the customer point of view. So this customer is going to be prompted at the very beginning to answer some questions. How did you find us? I found you through Google search. What do you expect from us? The best things. And where did you find us? Drop down field. I found you on Facebook. And I guess Facebook for the beginning. What are your main hobbies? I like to design and market. So let's click both of those. And you'll see in the back end that this is for onboarding step one. So this is only visible to customers that are not onboarded form one. And then this second one is visible to customers not onboarded form two. So if I press validate, it'll then bring me to the second onboarding questions. How will you use our? I will be using it to the best of my ability because that's all I can do. Being tongue in cheek here. What is your company size? Let's say it's 51 to 100. And how long have you been working in the industry? 3 years. Specifically, no longer, no less. You'll see once I'm in here, then I am brought to this page, which will show me various resources and their attached images. And I can filter them based by subject. So subject A is just gonna be a few resources here. And then subject B would be only a few resources as well. And as this person onboarding, if I go to your onboarding dashboard, it'll show all that information that I just inputted. So Facebook, the best things. I'm ridiculous. And all these different titles are based off of what we have in the back end. So if I wanted to, for the user onboarding information, it's just left as information 1, 2, 3, because the system is more of a baseline and we can change these names to say, for example, how long have you been working in the industry? For this one, what is your company size? And then adjust the forms to the different questions that you have and then change the property names accordingly. So for example, in this backend, you know, I could change what do you expect from us? You know, while it should go to information one, I could change the name of this or the question of this to something very different, right? So actually that would have been two. So what do you expect from us? I could say, how long have you known about us? And then in this backend, ask the question, how long have you known about us? Change it to a multi-select field. It's really up to you, right? But we want to get that information quickly and we want to then have it mapped to the customer dashboard, because this customer dashboard is going to show whether the person is onboarding complete or not. As you can see here, it's not showing because my onboarding is done. In the back end, this is really cool. This is shown from a visibility standpoint in the user group where customer is not onboarded for form one or form two. And this is set up so that if they're not onboarded, you're automatically sent to onboarding step one, which is exactly what I was sent to. And in the onboarding step one, very simply, as it showed earlier, it just has visibilities to make sure that we're keeping that process streamlined. Because when working with whoever you're working with, I'm sure it's been difficult to get the information out of them before they log into whatever system it is. But after I was finished with that, almost immediately, I had all of the different information I needed to input it. And then I'm able to access different resources that matter to me on the homepage. And then I could go to, for example, the help page here. And if I had any questions, I could say, I'm confused. Why is this so awesome? And then once the inquiry is sent in from the other side of things, not just the customer side, there are other people in the user groups. So for example, by the default user credentials, Laura is somebody I can use as an example for a member. So I'm gonna copy this magic link, show you how this works. But from a member standpoint, what we're gonna see is we're gonna see the customer inquiries. So we're gonna see inquiries that were treated or not treated. So if I scroll down, you can see that David, for example, is onboarded. Not onboarded people would be someone like Andy's right here. I can filter this at the top, and I also can search for anybody. So Diana, press enter and search the different names in there. I can click on Paul, for example, and it would show the record details as well as the help inquiries from this customer and what they have submitted. It would show all the same information that was on the onboarding page that he had. And this view up here is really just to showcase, you know, do we need anything to get done in general? Whereas this is more so to see the information of the people that we would be onboarding. We could save this as an image if we'd like. And this obviously doesn't have to be shown in a donut chart. What we can do is we could make a grid view, for example. And I would basically like to put a table block in here that snags the different inquiries. So if I were to grab my data source and then put the help inquiries in here and show the grid view. I go to the content section, can move this around. So for example, the status, you know, on the left here would be, oh, what's treated or not treated. I could have it filtered to be by the status, which would make the most sense to me. Have the colors be mapped to what the data source showcases. Hide these other ones that don't make as much sense. And then if I wanted to, I could also set up an action button that would allow me to add or edit records. So by going into this now, rather than just seeing a chart, I could see what are the total inquiries that exist. If I go to the team dashboard, I could see, oh, okay. So this is not treated, but I could edit it, or I could add a new record right here, as well as filter to not treated. And even more so, if I wanted to, I could set it up so that this conditional formatting could occur. I could make it so that rather than picking between treated and not treated, I can only see the ones that aren't treated. So for example, the status is not treated. Now I would only see basically what is pending, which I think makes the most sense. Then I could get rid of this filter altogether because honestly, we only really want to see what is remaining from a list standpoint. If I go into this once again, you could see the two remaining not treated inquiries, which is awesome. I mean, we have an onboarding system where people are able to put in their information immediately. And then from the team side, I see what isn't treated. I see what percentage of inquiries aren't treated. And I see who isn't and who isn't onboarded along with their information. This is what Softr Universe is all about, people. You guys are able to upload your different templates and make an impact on those other people who are in the Softr community. I mean, heck, we made an entire video about Matthew's template here, which I'm sure he is very appreciative about. If you want to check out this template, once again, make sure to check out the link down below and make sure to check out more videos like this one on how to improve your skills using Softr even more.